Prince Nazim Hamed was one of the most explosive and exciting fighters on the planet in 1998. With plans to take the USA by storm, the Prince first had to deal with tough Puerto Rican Wilfredo Vasquez in Manchester, England.
I have to say, the last time I saw Vasquez, he was a very lucky winner on points on the Holyfield Mora bill in Las Vegas. Now, is he going to learn from that exciting and explosive fight, Hamed, that he had with Kevin Kelly in Madison Square Garden when he lunged in rather recklessly? Now, he can't afford to do it with this fellow, but when he decides he wants to box, he can, Hamed. He comes right through the amateur ranks, and he does have the most explosive punch at the weight. But never underestimate a man who's done it all before. But he hits, watch this, from all various angles. I've never seen it. Usually you can compare boxers with somebody from the past, but no, I haven't with a Hamed. He can hit off balance, he can hit going back. And sometimes when he's hit the deck, a lot of it has been off balance, because I've seen him take solid whacks without going off over. And he had a sort of half tight punch because he's not balanced properly. He's leaning back, or he's just about to hop aside, and he'll hit the deck as he did with Kelly, which were only touchdowns in effect. But when he unloaded on Kelly, that was it. He spreads his legs, doesn't he, there? Gets a lot of anchorage when he throws a punch. Now, this is what they call ultra respect here, isn't it? They're a bit frightened to lead, both of them. Vasquez is known for his right hand over the top punches, over the leads, but against a southpaw, with Hamed, he may not be able to get away with it so easily. We shall see. That's called a bit of a sparring session now, sort of the old scouting report. Let's see what's going on. One thing you can count on is he's come in with more confidence, Vasquez, than a number of Hamed's opponents. By the time he gets him in the ring, you know, they're stiffening up with a little bit of stage fright. But this fella's too experienced for that. 61st professional fight. There's a chance, Nazim, the crowd are getting well behind him. But it looks as though he might have been listening to orders to say, don't start being reckless at the off. Pick your punches, do some boxing. He'll come at him, though. Threw him over there. He won't like that, Vasquez. He's got good reach. He's got exceptional deceptive reach, actually, Hamed. Because he turns his body right into it to get extra length. Well, Vasquez really didn't know what to make of that. Let's have a look round. I got thrown over, and I'll figure you out later, mate. That's about all he can say there, I think. So round two. And just a workout opening round, wasn't it? He fought a fellow called Jose Badillo in Sheffield like this. Hamed put on a boxing exhibition. He was picking his shots all the time. So different from, as I said, than any other fighter around. It doesn't mean he's better, but he's certainly different. This widespread stance that he's got. It's a wonder he doesn't fall off balance more often. So you fight him back. He's got all the guts in the world, Vaz, because he's been in a few melting pots. But when he throws these uppercuts, and they're really swings rather than uppercuts, I would say, from Hamed, they're full power. It's unusual to wipe the glove while he hasn't been on the deck, really. Great expectancy with the crowd here, because Hamid's not producing. He's been talking about two rounds, and I've never believed in naming rounds, although Muhammad Ali would disagree with that. But he didn't always call the right ones. It's a good gimmick coming into a fight. Be satisfied with a win. finding his range a bit, actually, I think, David, isn't he? Just flicking that right-hand lead out. As I said, don't write the old man off by any means. Just maybe later on in the fight, if it starts to take its toll. Is he going to go orthodox for a while? No, he's gone back to southpaw, Hammett. Hasn't been beaten since his junior amateur days. He never fought as a senior as an amateur. Against Dean Piffy, who's now a very successful pro. Oh, the old dropping of the hands now. We're getting oh, right hand punch on the button there. You see, I said to you that was the punch he would use, Vasquez. He's good with that. Good right cross. That just might have reminded Hamed not to do any clowning. Although with him, it's not clowning, it's his style. See, that was a good shot he took there. Now, in America, some of Kelly's shots weren't as good as that, and he went over. Because of the balance problem, I think. Because he's always trying to hit from difficult angles. He hasn't been foolish there, Hamed, has he? Took a good shot and said, oh, well, you know, you're not that bad, are you? I've got to give you some respect. Third round. So they're still a bit searching, aren't they? Neither of them really want to open up and take chances because they respect the other fella's countering. It looks like Vasquez is looking better than he did against the Nicaraguan I mentioned in Las Vegas last year. He hadn't got himself juiced up for that particular fight, but he has for this one. But in many ways, Vasquez is more hesitant than Hamed, really. I mean, he's so used to walk-on fighters that is, you know, from Puerto Rico and Japanese, that guys that he's fought that'll come at him. Oh. Done him with the left hook there. He's got to give him an 8 count there. He's not hurt by that punch, but he did definitely touch down. Yeah, sure, it's shaken him up. You would be hurt if you're on the deck, but it's not a punishing punch. Well, that'll give him some command in this round now, Hamed. Immense strength, natural ability with explosive power. Sort of thing you can hardly teach a boxer, really. He has it or he hasn't. He's missing wildly, Vasquez. He can't work him out. And he may not either. He may be clipped on the chin a bit, but if he throws punches at length like that and falls in with them. Oh, that's a good shot with the left hand, that was. See those sharp two punches on the turn there by Hamed. Just dying to reach his chin, Vasquez, but he's not in the mood for it, Hamed. He's taken over a bit now. He can afford a bit of a show-off. See how many people would leap in with a right-hand lead like that with an uppercut? Very few fighters could get away with it. Hamed does, takes the chances and does it. To him, they're not chances. He's practiced them for years. Looks like one punch could sort this one out, actually. I don't think it's going to be a sort of toe-to-toe standing battle. It's going to be cagey and who gets caught first, but more likely Vasquez, I would have thought. And he's pouring, isn't he, with that left-hand lead there, Vasquez. He's dying to get close to him, doesn't know how to. And you would have thought with his experience, but then again, nobody's faced anybody like Hamed in terms of style and power. Well, the prediction's gone anyway, so that's that got over. We can get down to being sensible now. Fourth round. It's not going to be an explosive fight, I don't think, anymore. I just think that Hamed is going to look for that payoff. And maybe, I don't think Vasquez will run out of desire. That's no good. He's too fired up for this one. But it's just not his type of fight. The cagey ones never did suit him too much. The battlers he could handle. Just look at the spread on his legs there. I've never seen anybody do that before. It's almost acrobatic. So far out of distance, Vasquez. You could hear the weight of that one coming in there. I'll just be that little touch of lead in the legs now of Vasquez, as I said, at 37 years of age and his 61st fight. All those long slogs that he's had over the years. He actually started off with Mike Tyson's managers, Bill Caton and Jim Jacobs, years ago. And won his first title when Hamed was 13. At least he's a proven and tried and tested champion. He's getting a reminder to keep the punches up there, Vasquez. By the American referee. So he'll walk onto one though. If he's going to start getting closer to Vasquez, Hamid's counter punching is going to nail him. So he may be overdoing that. Well, I keep calling them uppercuts, I suppose they are, but they look, they're so long, they're almost a swing, but he keeps using them, Hamid, and he certainly unloads some power with them. I think people may wonder about Hamid, what happens when he gets hit. Well, time's proven, he's only been down with Kelly and Alicia, but he'll bounce up off again. And in the gymnasiums over the years, they said, no, don't worry about his chin. He gets up all right, fights back. Now, he can't afford to get sloppy, actually, Hamid. He's got to accept that this fella's taken a few good shots and he's still in there. Oh, dear. He's got the up a bit now, Vasquez, isn't he? I think he's trying to roll Hamid into standing and trading, and he doesn't want that. The noise in the corner. No, I'm not having that, says the referee. Says Vasquez, he's saying, no, I'm sorry, mate, you got caught with a punch. Admittedly, you slipped afterwards. Well, that's doing him no favours in terms of judges. Be a 4-point round right away now for Hamid, unless, you know, if Vasquez got in and threw some punches, he can sometimes finish up with a draw, but by and large they lose the round with the slightest knockdown. See, he's often moving just that fraction away, Hamid, when he gets caught with a punch. The noise is unbelievable. With commentary position here with Sports Network is very close to Vasquez's corner, and I tell you, it's amazing what they get away with. I mean, the border control inspectors can forget their job, tapping them on the shoulder and keeping them quiet. Save that for some poor little sick grounder. Hey, well, the ring's collapsing. Oh dear, I thought for a minute he was, oh dear. Mike Goodall, the master of the ceremonies, is also the ringmaster. Oh dear. Now, we've had some goalposts collapsing recently. Now, what has happened there? Oh, dear. This is terrible. So he's going to wave play on now with a three-rope ring. I tell you what, in very difficult circumstances there, the ringmaster and co have done well. I know the crowd can't understand it, but, you know, these things happen. Look, he's still working on it to the end, but pulling them together so they won't separate so easily. And Frank Warren saying, get out of the way, mate. I didn't pay to come in, but I am putting the money up. Yeah. love to finish it now, wouldn't he, Nasazim Hamid? I mean, people have got a bit uptight about all that palaver. Love wiping the gloves instantly. There's no old-fashioned rosin dust on the floor anymore. Now let's see whether Frank Warren's demand, as it were, to Hamid, because I think he's worried about the clashing of heads there. His left ear looks a bit red in there, or is that my imagination with Hamid? See, the crowd will start baying that team on. They're used to it, you see. They don't really realize that Mr. Vasquez has been around a bit too long to go over easily. I see, he does create controversy. I'd like to do with him, Hamid, but you can bet the people for years will say, remember that night when the old rope broke? That was Hamid. He falls in a bit square, Vasquez, at times when he goes in with a punch. Certainly missing a lot. Oh, yeah. He did miss him with that. He gets angry with himself, Vasquez, when he goes over this. The embarrassment. It's for a world champion, you know, it gets a bit humiliating when you hit the deck. Now, is he going to go for it now? Nope, he hit the rope with that one. Yeah, he's got him going all right now. He staggered back from that. He could tell that last close. He was hurt. And none of those counter punches are bothering Hamid. Yeah, this is complete boxing by Hamid now. He's standing his distance a bit now. He's getting a bit closer so that he can get some full leverage in his blows. He thinks Vasquez will slightly come apart now. Being sensible, Hamid. He's definitely learned from that palaver in four rounds with Kevin Kelly in America. Oh, that stopped him short in his tracks, didn't it? He's just not landing any punches, Vasquez. He's getting well outpointed. Oh, it's legs then. They started to go. He's going to get knocked over. He is going to get knocked over here. Because if he can't control his legs, he can't control the fight. No. He might let him go on, but I doubt it. He's giving him a longer... Plenty of eight there. He's getting up to eight. He's calling it in Spanish so that he understands it. Are you all right? You get back in again, but it's just walking back into the fire again. All over. And the crowd gone raving mad here, as you would expect. Bingo, straight through that left hand. It's a hell of a shot. You don't see that one coming. It's almost as though he's hiding it before he unleashes. But that's a sign of an old roadie. He's just had a fight too much and doesn't know how to control himself.
The winner and still champion, and because of this, his victorious 10th world title defense, he's recognized by the WBO as Super World Champion, Prince Hefty Hamid.
Well, Michael Buffer, the American MC there, summed it up pretty well, didn't he? Super champion of the world. There's no denying it. This fellow is.
That was 1998, and Nassim Hamed was in seventh heaven against Wilfredo Vasquez. The Prince would remain unbeaten until 2001, when Mexican Marco Antonio Barrera showed the world that he was the real featherweight king.